So let's leave that behind. Let's talk about your practice specifically. So you've got a new patient, and let's say you got a patient that's who I was 5 years ago, 400 pounds, crazy high blood pressure. I had metabolic syndrome. I had a lot of things going wrong with me, asthma, things like this. What's that process look like for you? How are you onboarding them? How are you counseling them? And then how are you walking them through the steps of making, you know, lasting lifestyle changes?
Yeah, look, and I suppose each approach is a little bit different to each individual person. It very, very much depends on, and you've given an example there, on where the person's at, what they've tried before, what their conditions are, what their medications are, and you know, I suppose where they're at in their life. So I think the beginnings of it is, well, how have you arrived at this point? I mean, we have to go back a little bit and get a little bit of background as to, you know, how they reached this point. What have they been doing? Was there a time when some of these conditions, wasn't something that they had? You know, have they accumulated different medications over the years? What sort of things have they done that has tried and not worked? And obviously that leads into one of the things that I always ask people to do is keep a food diary for a week. And I do stress that it's not an exam. There is no right or wrong answer. In some respects, the worse it is, the almost the better, because it gives us more ground, you know, more opportunity to make change. If people are in a bad way and they're doing everything right, it's a little bit harder. And then I'm a very, very firm believer in trying to keep things fairly simple. And I think sometimes diet, and that's whether it's the standard in inverted commas diet or a low carb diet, you know, it can be made harder than it needs to be. And people think, well, you know, what am I going to have for lunch on Tuesday? And, you know, what if I eat something that's wrong? And I think it's about emphasizing to people that, number one, it's not a religion. Number two, that low carb is not the same as no carb. So if it's Sunday and you want to go out for breakfast and you want to have a slice of toast, you know what? The world's not going to stop spinning. So don't feel that, you know, you can never have anything that's got some carbs in it. However, if we want to make some change, then we have to go back to the 80-20 principle. And certainly at the start, people are eating a lot of breakfast cereals, if they're eating a lot of bread, rice, pasta, snack foods, you know, all those sorts of foods, then that is what's going to need to change. And then people say, well, you know, what does that leave me with? Well, the answer to that is pretty much what your grandparents probably ate, which is meat, fish, chicken, or other forms of protein, vegetables, maybe a little bit of fruit, not that much, because yes, there is sugar in fruit, and some nuts and seeds, and drink mainly water. And that's the basics. Yeah. That is the basics. And, you know, whether you want to have steak or whether you want to have lamb chops or whether you want to have salmon, you know, it doesn't really matter. And it is also important for people, if they are overweight, that, you know, portion size still does have a role. It's a lot easier when you're low carb. But you know what? If you eat 5 kilos of steak, it's still probably a bit more than you should be eating. So, it sounds silly when you put it like that. But it is about, with each person, understanding where they're at. And also, it's no point telling people to eat foods that they don't like. So you have to sort of work with the individual and say, well, what can we arrive at that is going to work for you? And that ultimately is not, and this is a really important point, not about being on a diet, but about changing your eating patterns, not just for the next 3 or 6 weeks or months, but, you know, hopefully for the rest of your life.
You know, the 80-20 principle is argued about, I think, quite a bit, because you have some people that can do that, that can, you know, they'll eat a piece of bread once a week and, you know, be just fine. And then you have other people that are very much like addicts, that if they eat a piece of bread, it sends them into the spiral where they're eating, you know, an entire loaf a day, and you're undoing a lot of the work that you did before. Have you run into that? Do you see that is something that you see with your clients?
Look, everybody is different, and you know, clearly what works for one person doesn't for the others. I think at the start, when making changes, there's two approaches. One is just basically wholesale changes. Just from day one, you just got to cut out you know, pretty much everything you're doing and start from scratch. Mm-hmm. Equally, I had somebody come to see me literally last week who said, look, she'd gone on to and she'd not seen me before, she was seeing another doctor, had gone on to a ketogenic type of diet and said, look, I've been doing this now for 3 months. The first 2 months, I wanted to ease myself into it. And the last month I've been, you know, pretty strict and full on. And that's the other way of going. So, you know, I don't believe one wants to be too, you know, prescriptive in this. And some people are a little bit, you know, more or less carb sensitive, and some of that revolves around their insulin sensitivity. So some people, if they're, you know, their insulin systems are still pretty good, look, they may well have some, you know, some carbs and it won't affect them too much. Other people are going to be very, very, very sensitive. And for some people, it is also that psychological thing that if I have one piece, I might as well have 20 pieces. So this is, you know, finding out what works for people. But I think it is so important. It is so important that if, this is with anything you're doing in your health and with your life, if you're on a program and you drift a bit off the rails, then you can always get back on the rails. You know, if Sunday things didn't go your way, Monday's another day. And I think sometimes when people, you know, stub their toes or trip up or do the wrong, in inverted commas, thing, and they, oh, look, I might as well give it all away now. No, whatever you did yesterday, fine, reset for today, and away we go again. I think that's really important.